My name is Dragan Simic. I'm working for Austrian Institute of Technology. I presented something about modeling simulation of entire vehicle and how to do it in Modelica using Wolfram System Modeler.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And hello, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, why I'm here and why I want to present you. I want to present you something about modeling and about simulation for automotive applications. Finally, at the end, I want to show you how to simulate an entire vehicle or whole vehicle and why is it important to simulate an entire vehicle. And okay, we can start with the title. It's, as you can see, modeling and evaluation of the smart cooling library for the simulation of the thermal management in automotive application. Okay, you can also see here the authors, Mr. Dvorak, Bäumel, and Capella. Mr. Capella support me by this presentation. And yes, I'm working for Austrian Institute of Technology. This is the biggest non-university research center in Austria, located in Vienna. Okay, I would like to give you a briefly outline of this presentation, something about the introduction. Okay, why we need entire vehicle simulation and why we have to understand everything related to modeling in simulation. Okay. For example, if you want to optimize or analyze or investigate a vehicle concept, you have to understand everything. You cannot only, for example, simulate a component, for example, air conditioning system. You can say, okay, I want to optimize my air conditioning system, but you have to understand entire vehicle. You cannot optimize your air conditioning system separately. You have to do it in entire vehicle or entire modeling model. This is very important for me, and this is also the reason why I want to present here some activities related to this optimization and finally analysis. Okay, I want to go then very quickly to smart cooling library. This is a library that we developed for simulation of the thermal management, I mean cooling system for internal combustion engines, electrical machines, and so on. Then I want to go to model description very quickly to explain you how is it possible to model and to simulate. Then, of course, I say we can simulate everything. It's not a problem to simulate a system, a car or a water pump or a cooling system. But you have to validate this, okay? And this is the point why I have here also testing bed and measurement description, why we need this. We have to validate all vehicle components if we want to analyze this. Okay, and finally, I want to show you a comparison between simulation, measurements and simulation, and short conclusion of this work, okay? Something about this developed smart cooling library, you can see, okay, it's written in Modelica language. You know what this Modelica language is. This is a language, object-oriented language that I can simulate everything in a model. I mean, I can do multi-physical simulation, including electrical, mechanical, thermal, and so on behavior of a component. This is very important to understand. If you have, for example, an electrical machine, I have to understand everything in this machine, mechanical parts and electrical parts. Okay, the focus is clear. Okay, and as I said, if I want to optimize or simulate a thermal management of a car, I have to simulate all components, and I need all components, as you can see here. I need water pumps, I need all electrical, mechanical, components like cooling fan, like cooler, pipelines, thermostat, and so on. Okay, something about cooler model. Okay, if we are talking about cooler model, okay, I have to understand, I have to model convention, in this model. I need some equations. I don't have so much time to explain this everything, but I need Nusselt number, I need Reynolds number, and I have, based on these numbers and based of medium that I have in my cooling system, for example, I have also air and water. I need information about this medium. I can then identify, for example, based also on geometry of the cooler, I can identify type of flow in my cooler. For, I'm talking about water flow and air flow. And based on this, I can identify these all numbers, like Reynolds number and so on. And based on this Reynolds number and Nusselt number, I can calculate then a convection between fluid and solid, in this case, between water, then solid of the cooler, and then air finally. You can see on this picture identification, or how is it possible to calculate. For example, here we have lamina, area, transient area between lamina and turbulent area, and here turbulent area. This is very necessary to understand how works it, to calculate, of course, thermal behavior. Okay, this is the next step. The next step is to create a model in Modelica. Of course, we need control volumina if we want to simulate our cooler. It's not possible to simulate only in a model. We have to do discretization of this model. And as you can see, we used also some standard components from Modelica library here, like medium models. Okay, then you can also see here schematic how we modeled it. You can here see here pipeline of the water pipeline. This is here the segments of the cooler, and here finally the segments of the airflow in this cooler. And okay, this is, for example, they are the results based on this model. You can see that we use discretization at about 20 times 20. Sorry, this is a mistake. We have here 400 control volumes. I'm so sorry. And you can also see, I can identify also location or position of the cooling fan. I can define also the speed of the cooling fan, and I can then calculate this heat transfer between water and air. And finally, I can use this model in entire vehicle simulation. Okay. The next step is also, this is another example how to model, for example, a water pump. As I said at the beginning, it's very important to understand all components in the car. And this is the second the part of this presentation or example. Okay, I have to understand also water pump, how works it. It's also not very easy to simulate this and to find right equation for this model. And you can simulate this component like ideal flow machinery. You can very easy find these equations, but you need also all losses, equations of all losses in this for this model or for this water pump, like decrease of specific energy, then flow losses, then losses of the operating medium, and so on, as you can see here. Okay, the first step is to find the main equation, as you can see here, this equation. Okay, using this equation, you can define this characteristic of the water pump. Normally, we have in automotive area, we have a water pump with this characteristic here, as you can see. Okay, and this is equation of the fluid flow machinery, but you don't have the losses. You need the losses to model this correctly. And the first that we have to define is decrease of the specific energy. You can see you need some equations. I don't have time to explain this everything, how to find these equations and so on. We also need some experience data from literature maybe and so on. It's not very easy also to find all parameters here. And finally, after implementation of this equation in the model, you can see we change this characteristic line of the water pump. Okay, this is the first step. The next step is to identify hydraulic losses in shower canals, channels between the blades in the water pump. Then the next step is to identify impact losses. And finally, as you can see on this picture, this is the characteristic line of this water pump, and this between are the losses in the flow machine. Okay. The next step is to identify friction losses of the impeller between impeller and housing of the pump. It's very easy to find this equation and to implement this equation, and you can also see here power losses or impeller speed of the water pump. The next step is also, as I mentioned, to evaluate this. You need then water pump of the testing bed, and you have to measure this. And we used in this case a conventional water pump from a BMW X3, and we put this water pump on the testing bed, and we identified volume flow of the water volume flow, pressure different, inlet, outlet, and we identified also the torque and speed, I mean the power of the pump. Okay, you can see here some nominal data of this water pump. You can also see here the water pump on the testing bed. Here is the device for torque measurement. Here is the electrical machine for speed, of course, and power. And you can also see here the some measurement pressure devices for pressure measurement. After this measurement, we use this data for validation of this model. And there are here the results, as you can see here, these two lines. They are the lines of the specific revolution or speed of the water pump. And you can see here the correlation, for example, for speed, for different speeds here. And what we can see also that the model is has the same characteristic like the reality. Thank you very much. I have 5 minutes more. Okay, I have to be faster. Okay, the next step is then to evaluate, to measure entire vehicle. Okay, and as you can see here, we have also entire vehicle on the test or dynamometer, and we identify all parameters of the vehicle and values, and we measured also everything from, for example, from power of the engine, torque, speed, fuel consumption, temperatures, and so on. I think more at about 350 variables that normally we need for evaluation of the model. Okay, this is the model in Modelica, as you can see here. I have a driver, strategy, cycle, and ambient. I need a driver for regulation of the gas pedal, brake pedal, clutch pedal, and so on. I need strategy for some components. Driving cycle, it can be constant speed, it can be new European driving cycle, real life cycle, and so on. Ambient, you can see here chassis, including all resistance of the car, and here internal combustion engine, cooling system, and entire powertrain. The next point is that I want to explain you the model of the cooling system. As you can see, we have here water pump that we modeled in this area. We have here the cooler, here the engine, thermal model of the engine, fan, and so on. All components that you have also in a conventional car. And of course, you have to validate all of these components to be sure that you can also investigate or analyze this car or system. Okay, this is the comparison between measurement and simulation. As you can see here, car speed, comparison between measured and simulated data. Here we have the engine speed, internal combustion engine speed. The next slide is more interesting for us, and you can see here a comparison between measured temperature of internal combustion engine block temperature, and here also the comparison between measured and simulated coolant temperature at cooler outlet. And of course, in this case, we can say that we are sure that our comparison between measurement and simulation are very good, and that we can use these models for optimization. Okay, there are only the results. All oil temperature comparison and fuel consumption of the car, as you can see in here, correlation between these two lines. Okay, and finally, yes, we can use this model for simulation of the entire vehicle. We need this if we want to optimize, for example, a concept, a car, and we can also change some components. We can also remove the mechanical water pump, for example, and we can implement electrical water pump, and we can compare efficiency, and we can optimize fuel consumption, for example. Okay, I can use also these thermal models also for simulation of electrical cars. I can simulate, for example, thermal management of battery, of electrical machines, and of the all components. But in every case, it's very important that we understand entire vehicle, and for example, only something about performances of the simulation using, based on this model, using Wolfram system modeler, we can simulate, for example, in 24 hours, more than 1 million driving cycles. And we can optimize this very, very fast. And this is the point of also this presentation for me. Okay, I am at the end. Thank you very much.